it's Bernie, and I've got Toyin here with me today. Do you want to say hi?
Hi.
Hi. Like I mentioned previously, the BMAT test, I haven't done the BMAT test, I've never ventured into it. But because a lot of you have been asking about the BMAT test, about tips and advice, so I thought to get someone that's done a BMAT test. So you did your test about 2 years ago now, because we're in second year. But she's just going to share her tips and advice and general experience of the BMAT test, basically. So if we start off with your experience, how was your experience with the BMAT?
So I was the only one in my school doing it. And I didn't have a lot of support from my school.
Yeah.
And I didn't know anyone else doing it. So it was all very new to me. So I used the 400 questions book.
Okay.
And
so is that like similar to the
The 600 UK, one?
Yeah. Mm. Okay.
It's the same company. So for me, it was at a time when I had quite a heavy workload in my A levels. So I kind of had to, I was prioritizing the BMAT, so I kind of let my A levels slip a bit. But it was alright. Like once that was over, I just picked up the work. And the actual exam was I was alone in this art room with this one invigilator guy, and it was a bit weird, but
Yeah, because you're the only one that did the exam. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that was your general experience.
Mm-hmm.
Not too great because you're the only person.
Yeah.
I know you mentioned that you used the 400 UKCAT. Look at me, I'm so used to UKCAT. 400 BMAT book. Is there any other how did you find that, and was there any other resources you used as well?
I liked the book. It has a lot of tips and things.
Okay.
And that was my main resource. I used GCSE textbooks because one of the sections is sciences and maths, the second section. I also used past papers, so I found them on a free website, so you could just Google it and you'll find something like that. So yeah, that was mostly what I used.
Okay. Did you venture into any going in a course or something? And then you said that prior.
No, but it would have probably helped. Mm. Because I ended up with just an average score, so it wasn't competitive. So
we've talked about your experience, the resources you used. How did you study for this? Because obviously it's a bit different from the UKCAT test, where it's a online test and you're practicing online, obviously, but it's a practice online. How did you genuinely study for the exam, for the BMAT exam?
So I finished my UKCAT in August. Okay. And then I started studying for the BMAT. But I started really knuckling down in October time, a month before. I was really just using GCSE science books mostly. So the first section is an aptitude test section. It's pretty much common sense, but the trick to that one is just practicing and doing lots of questions.
Practice and everything, practice.
Yeah. And that one, there's a bit of a time constraint, but it's not too bad, so do that under time conditions. And it's also multiple choice. Don't be afraid to just
guess. Yeah. You can't do it. You've got a 25%, well, depending on how many options are there, you've got a 25% chance of getting it right. So just guess and move along.
Exactly. The second section was the science bit. So mostly GCSE books. I use the CGP ones.
Good old CGP.
Yeah. And then I took some notes from those, just basic short flashcard things. And I did some online quizzes, just GCSE quizzes. The 400 questions book was very useful for that section.
So would you advise people getting that?
Definitely.
Okay.
And then the third section is essay writing. So I made a lot of essay plans when I was practicing for it.
Okay.
But I didn't write a lot of essays because you're scored on two things, your content and your grammar. So if you've already got decent grammar, you don't need to spend time writing anything else. Towards a few weeks coming up to the exam, you should be writing them out. But you want to focus on content.
being the only person there, having no support. Mm-hmm. Is there anything you wish you did back then, knowing that you didn't have as much support in terms of studying it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wish I'd gone on a course.
Then go on the course then. And I'm aware, like, now anyway, they do two exams. Apparently, we're doing just one. There's just one in November.
In November.
But now, apparently, they do it both sometime before September and now. So because of the way the BMAT works, you don't know your results before you apply and things like that, yada, yada, yada. But just obviously, like I always say, it's, well, not just for this year anyway, for next year, if you're looking for 2018, see what applies better to you. Do you want to focus more on your UKCAT during the summer and then do the BMAT later on, or just mix both together and just get it over and done with? What would you say about genuinely on the day of the exam, what to do, how to tackle questions?
Just make sure you've had like a decent breakfast and like rest before. Try to like calm yourself down before and like bring water into the exam. Make sure you're going in ready.
What do you mean ready? Like, so, you've got your content?
Okay. So, like, for me, the night before, I did, like, one or two past papers.
And finally, your general tips and advice. We've probably touched on this, but...
Yeah. So, like, my main tip is do, like, an essay writing subject if you can. Like, obviously, if you're not, like, into that, then... it's not a good idea, but if you can do one for AS level, you should do one because you'll be finishing that just before your BMAT. So I did English literature, which helped me a lot for the essay subject, for the essay section. And then what else? So for my maths modules, I did mechanics, which helped me. Well, I mean, that wasn't obviously like physics GCSE level, but it sort of
would have mechanics. Nah, yeah. <initials.
laughs> So yeah, you want to do things that are relevant to like what's going to come up on the BMAT. So yeah,
but then regardless, it's kind of a bit too late because you've already started your like already done your AS levels and A level. Like you've already picked your A level.
Yeah. Well, so, if you're in like year 11.
Okay. Then... Yeah. Fair enough. If you're in younger years, like, and you're thinking of going to universities, what are the universities anyway? Because not all universities request a BMAT, just specific unis. So I know Oxford and Cambridge.
Oxford and Cambridge.
Imperial,
UCL.
Nottingham.
Do they? I'm not sure.
I looked, because I wanted to go into Nottingham, and I swear maybe I saw something that said BMAT, and I was like, nope, bye. But maybe it was a GAMSAT, I don't know, for like graduate entry, but yeah.
I think Brighton.
Okay. Brighton and Sussex, yes.
And there's like maybe one or two more.
Mm. Yeah, just I think quite a few, maybe six or seven genuinely.
Yeah.
But if you are looking to go into any of these universities, then you require a BMAT test, and in any other unis, it's a UKCAT test. Okay, so that's everything we've got today. Thank you guys for watching. I hope it's been helpful. I hope you were able to take some tips and advice from this, and good luck in your BMAT exam. Good luck.